What I think of this one, I think the eye just... There's something beautiful about humans and their senses, and once it's like brought into scope more clearly, it makes you, it gives you a sense of awe. It makes you reinterpret why we're here in the first place.
Oh, okay, thank you.
I feel like the strongest representing all five senses.
Yeah. Beginning with the eye.
She, yes, it begins with the eye, and the tears come because she can hear something coming, and she can see it coming too. But she doesn't taste the fear yet. But she's still trying to capture what's going on and what's going to happen. And she's looking up, as it seems in the photograph.
Mm-hmm.
She's looking up for a way out of it.
Oh, okay.
That's what I see.
First round, we're going to have Michael Petronio from Morrow. And he's going to play his guitar. And he's going to play the national anthem. Okay, so can we have a round of applause?
My beloved mother.
Oh, you need the mic?
Bigger buildings, longer trains, but you know we haven't won.
It's not worth upsetting your mom, soaring over our foolish loss. How long can we ignore this? Are we prepared for the cost? We become selfish. We don't think about our kids. We don't care about the aftermath, but the sake of our children and their children, please don't give us your wrath. We said we'd take care of you, but still we broke our promise. We've developed our cities and burned your forests. We've contaminated your water and polluted your air. We were supposed to be strong, but how long can we bear? Today, we get our pleasure inside. Before, we played in the yard. You used to be our identity, now it's a passing part. We connect with thousands of people indoors through our phone. Yet, many people claim they are alone. How is it that the world is at our gasp, yet we're confused? Our ears have become deaf, our eyes are blind, and our hearts closed. We break your laws and disregard your rules. We use up your oil and waste your fuel. I know we take more than we give you, and we owe you. I promise we won't forget. We will cherish you, appreciate you. Believe me, we're in doubt. We don't care. We're reckless. Oh, my beloved Mother Nature. I know this is selfish to say, but while we kill you, you have to be our savior. You have to be patient for as long as you are here. I'll be here praying that you live long enough to see us change.
Here, you can call the
cafeteria.
Yeah, I don't
know.
Hey,
you
know,
I'm
why
you
asking for money? Why are you asking for money? Why? Because I pay you.
Because we already
paid. Okay. We already paid.
Why
are you asking for money? Don't ask for money. I pay you already. I give you your money back already.
Guy, you didn't pay.
Of course I pay you. I'm not lying. I pay you.
Where's the line?
Arrest you and you have to pay him.
I don't have money because I pay him already. Why
yeah,
you asking for the money again?
Already.
You are drunk too much.
I'm not drunk too much. I drink for my money, then I pay.
Thank
you, sir.
Thank you.
Whatever.
is alcohol not good for your body and your physical or mental health?
Again, it's the amount. But if you drink too much alcohol, it's probably one of the most dangerous drugs you can have. It affects every single organ of the body, every single organ.
It makes you gain weight. And just because I'm heavy doesn't mean I drink a lot, just letting you know. But it also affects your kidneys. It affects your liver. It affects your brain. Every time you drink, you lose brain cells. So if you drink enough, you become less smarter. And also over time, it just makes you look old and it makes you age faster. So there's a lot of physical effects that come with it. The mental effects, well, it can cause depression, and it makes those problems that you're trying to fix, makes them worse.
Written by Brianna Rivas, and its title Won't Be There.
All you have to say. Anyone caught your eyes in particular?
Just the one that really caught my eye. That's one right there.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that was done by one of our classmates. Her name is Jessica.
Jessica?
Yeah.
This one also. I can't really read it. What is it saying? Enjoy life. Be happy.
The shirt, because you was like,
it looked like it's a positive type of thing. It's positive.
Okay. This one comes. He was all the way over there. He starts moving closer.
Any other one?
Good. With the bird. This one right here. I want all the cats in the world.
Yeah, that was done by one of our classmates named Brittany.
The next piece is an original piece written by Brianna Rivas, and its title Won't Be There.
I
Okay, now we're going to have our closing piece by Michael, Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
That's one in the jar, Mike. One in the jar.
Yeah, that is. That is. Before we have the closing.
From the book.
From the book. So Starfire, you're first.
Go for it.
Go ahead.
The name of my poem is actually called My Dreams. My dream. Dreams are like a movie. You can dream about whatever you want. Dreams are like flowers that keep growing and growing. There are ways that dreams do come true. It's like a reality just waiting to come out to the world. It's like you're thinking of different things coming together in your own little world. Dreams are like a television show that only you can see in your mind. Dreams are like you flying as high as you can, feeling free like touching the sky, making it to the top as you dream. Why dream? Why dream because you might be scared to dream about something? But guess what? Make your mind go running to wherever you want to go. It's like you're having a different life. You're living. Don't let anyone say you can't dream about anything because that is a lie. Therefore, live your dreams and don't let them down.
Good job. Good job.
and now we have Tiffany from Dr. Susan Smith McKinney.
My poem is entitled Antigua Nice. It's about the island, small island in the
Caribbean.
In the Caribbean, it's called Antigua and Barbuda. I don't know if many of you heard of it.
Yes.
It's pretty nice. Yeah. Antigua Nice feels like paradise. Antigua Nice, show it for the world to see. Antigua Nice, are we living unity? If you love this country, I want to see your flags in the sky. Hi, hi. If you love Antigua, participate, come celebrate. Fly it, fly it, fly it high, high, straight up to the sky. Fly it, fly it, fly it high, high, show it for the world to see. Show the world it's your flag, show the world that you're glad. Show the world it's your rag, Antigua, you come from. Carnival fun, carnival nice, carnival is popular in our paradise. Dance up, jump up, wave up. That's the way we do it, I hope you'd really knew it. Red, white, black, gold, and blue, hey, that's kinda new. Costume made from sprinkles and sequins, different size, different shape, different color. If you love this country, raise your flags in the sky, hi, hi. If you love Antigua, participate, come celebrate. The poem is about change. Change is never. Change is never easy. You fight to own and you fight to let go. Life is too short to wake up in the morning with regrets. So love the people who treat you right and forget about the ones who don't. We change, we don't like to change. We feel it. But we shouldn't stop it from coming and try to convince with that there. And something in every day, because when you take a closer look, this world is pretty evil place. Change can happen slowly or quickly. Change can be scary, but you know what? Scary. Allowing fear to stop you from going and progressing. For example, I need to change my life and I need to get my diploma to get to college. I need to get a better life in my education and the job and enough money to become comfortable and live a long life. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. One more. Can we have a round of applause for
our performers? Okay. So what age did you start playing the guitar?
Okay. I used to say it when I was little, but I used to kind of hide it. Growing up was too hard, and everybody told me to stick in that lane, so I felt like I had to stick in that lane. But then I got my first guitar, and I started writing, and just
went from there. Is that one of your hobbies?
Yes, I write, I sing, I play guitar.
Okay, and when like when you get older, do you want to like be somebody like?
I want to pursue music.
Oh, okay.
Some music producer or performance.
Okay, thank you. So this is yours, right?
Oh yes, it is. Yes, it is.
What inspired you to draw this?
I'm very big on Black culture. You know, I like culture. I mean, I like culture in general, but it was something about this that just came to my mind. Like, I don't even know who it is, but I know it's somebody who really means a lot and who cares about the importance of political rights and stuff like that.
Oh, okay.
He can't, like, he just...
So it just came out of your head, like,
yeah,
to draw it?
Like, it's, just,
it's no one in specific?
It's something that just came to me. Just something that just came to me.
Oh, okay. All right. Thank you.
You're so welcome.
What did you think about the art show?
I thought it was very out. I thought it was very unique. And I thought, we saw some very talented people today, including my dear friend Michael, who played the guitar, which was really nice. But I gotta go somewhere to buy.
Hungry.
Somebody help me, please. I'm a homeless person. Please help me.
I think people become homeless for a variety of kind of social and economic factors. I think more often than not, people are living paycheck to paycheck. And then if something happens where they don't have money coming in, maybe it happens really quickly that they're homeless.
So it's something that is a reality and that can affect anyone. I also work with students that some of them can't afford to live in a home, and I think it's important that there's a lot of awareness around this subject.
This is another DJ Metro One exclusive. DJ Metro One in the mix.
Yeah.
Metro One in the mix.
to the sound of the underground. Somewhere far, far away.
Singing a medley of Frank Sinatra.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
The students can stand.
Okay. Thank you.
I love the art show. It's wonderful.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi.
Did you like the art show?
I absolutely love the art show. I'm so proud of all my students who came out and showcased their talents. It's never easy to go up in front of an audience to speak or to sing or to act, but I think everyone did a wonderful job.
Okay. Any piece that you like in particular?
You know what? I really love all the pieces. I was looking at this one in particular. I love the eye, and I think that there's a story even behind this page, this drawing. I think that art is about people's interpretation, and I think this being just an eye lends itself to so many different interpretations, so I really love this one.
I was telling Mr. Mancuso how proud I am of our school, our site, and the whole Brooklyn site, because this is such a wonderful experience for our students to get something different out of the box, really being creative and present something wonderful, and everybody's so proud.
Thank you.